We are going to use bra.
Papa Flammy's advent calendar.
Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to Papa Flammy's advent calendar. Integrals have an end. We are going to deal with the final boss today. The integral of secant of t dt. I have never formally evaluated this integral on this channel. It's a standard integral, and I might as well do it. So here goes, let us give it a shot. At first, let us rewrite this bitch boy, and I'm going to show you the method I use. I just can't remember the result of this thing. It's something with natural log. That's the only thing I know. Never mind. I always have to derive it yet again. So this is 1 over the cosine of t integrated with respect to t. Okay. I fucking hate when certain people just multiply this thing by who knows what they multiply it with, something secant plus tangent. I don't know. It's the most stupid thing ever. It's the most pretentious thing ever. Here, look at me. I can multiply stuff together and I'm fucking cool. Yeah, if I know the end result of an integrand, I just substitute the shit in, then yeah, obviously it's quite easy. Okay, we're going to do it the elementary way. What we can probably do is introduce a substitution at some point. But the thing is, if you were to just substitute the cosine right here, that's kind of pointless because you are going to end up with the negative sign yet again. So that's kind of shitty, okay, when doing the substitution. So what we would like to do is to get a sign up here in some way, or a cosine or something. Something that just ends up nicely after doing substitutions. Meaning we have a nice relationship, namely that cosine squared plus sine squared is equal to 1. Meaning if we were to multiply top and bottom by the cosine, okay, this is the most logical thing you could probably do. There are probably other ways too. You're going to end up with cosine over cosine squared, okay? But cosine squared, by this relationship, fundamental theorem of trigonometry, okay, you're going to end up with 1 minus the sine squared. So we are going to have the cosine of t over 1 minus the sine squared of t integrate with respect to t. And I think this way really makes sense. I don't know if you ever saw this way, if you have ever seen this way before, but it's what I do. It's kind of easy because now we have the sine right here, but squared. Okay, I'm going to put it like this. And now if we were to substitute the sine, so let, what nice variable could we possibly use? Let us use something that's really, we are going to use bra. Okay, bra is thus equal to the sine of t. That's fucking stupid. Okay, and we are going to say that d bra is thus equal to the cosine of t dt. Okay, and it does make perfect sense because now we have d bra up here. Okay, this is something that we have. Okay, we are going to have d bra over 1 minus bra squared. And this is quite easy to evaluate. Now we can do partial fractions, okay, because this thing down here in the denominator is nothing other than 1 minus bra times 1 plus bra. And yeah, basically we can do partial fractions now. I don't really have it in my head. Let me see what partial fraction is going to end us up with. Okay, we are going to have an integral of something over 1 minus bra and plus something over 1 plus bra. If we were to multiply those together, we are going to have 1 plus bra and 1 minus bra. Bra and bra is going to cancel out. We are going to have 2, so we are going to have a factor of 1 half right here, right? Yes, exactly. This should work. D bra. Like I said, I don't have the results in my head. I have to think about everything I do each and every time. This is just dog shit. Why should you have the integral secant in your head? Seriously, it really doesn't make any sense. Now, we can continue from this point onward. And we can basically just substitute stuff now. So we can substitute this denominator by some other variable. So let 1 minus bra be equal to u, for example, meaning we are going to get negative dbra being equal to du. And the same thing holds for this thing right here, just with a positive sign instead of a negative sign, meaning we are going to end up with 1/2 times the integral of, yes, right, we are going to have negative du over u, and then plus 1/2 times the integral of, let's call it u once again, du over u, and this is going to result in 1/2 times the natural log of 1 plus bra minus the natural log of 1 minus bra. And now we can use natural log properties and bring those two together, meaning we are going to end up with, okay, let us plug all the other stuff in at first. Bra is nothing other than the sign. So we are going to have 1/2 times the natural log of 1 plus the sign of t minus the natural log of 1 minus the sine of t. Okay. And now let me see what this is going to result in. I mean, it's going to result in probably something nice. Okay, that's natural log of 1 plus the sine of t over 1 minus the sine of t. But if I remember correctly, and also plus some arbitrary constant c, this is not going to be the standard result that you are used to. Let me see, if I remember correctly, you are going to end up with something tangent, secant, something. How could you possibly get that? I'm not certain right now. You can somehow get to the standard result, but I think this is already a valid result. Probably you can drag the 1/2 into here and get the square root, but this is going to end up with, if you multiply top and bottom by 1 plus sine of t is going to give you 1/2 the natural log of 1 plus sine of t squared over 1 minus sine squared is nothing other than the cosine squared of t. And now we can track the 1/2 into here as the square root, meaning we are going to end up with the absolute value, so natural log of the absolute value of 1 plus the sine of t over the cosine of t is thus nothing other than 1 over cosine is the secant, and then plus the tangent, and also plus some arbitrary constant shit. Okay, so this is nothing other than natural log of secant of t plus the tangent of t in absolute values plus some arbitrary constant c, and then we are done. I thank you guys for watching. I hope you did enjoy the bra substitution. Okay, this is groundbreaking stuff right here. And if you want to support channel by those teachers, I created 10 to 15% of everything in Papa Flammy's shop over the course of the whole December. Up until the next video, have a Hakuromo Chaik day. Love him, my boy. Ciao. And I love you guys too, okay? I'm not only loving my Hakuromo Chaik, I love you guys too, even more than my Hakuromo Chaik. See ya.